Well, there's a lot of responsibility coming after a band with no name and Jonathan. But and it's a little scary to be the person who's going to come up here right after that funk and talk about big data. Big data. Now, when you think about big data, you might think about, you know, what does the theatrical CIA look like, you know, or what does, you know, what data, major data sets are there. But we're going to look at big data in a different way, in a way that I think you'll relate to and the like, because we're going to look at big data as it relates to Broadway in this sense. So rather than make it this highly technical, analytical thing, let's go to a different way we might think about big data. Let's look at what you would put up on a comedy improvisational wall in that sense. Now, we're going to add some interaction to our process here, and I want you to do me a favor. To the left, to right, and back of you is somebody either who you know or you randomly sat with, okay? I want you to turn to them really quickly. What's a piece of data that you wish that producers and other people who put on Broadway shows knew about you? Okay, so if you think about how we create the best possible Broadway for you, what's a piece of data about you that you wish that we all knew? So just turn to your neighbors quickly. It'll be about 30 seconds of that. Hello? Now, in the old Broadway, I would read from the script, right? In fact, Broadway is about a story, and a story always has a script. But as we think about the evolving case, please get ready to catch this. I'm throwing a microphone out to you. Okay, would somebody catch that? Okay, oh, you caught it, okay. So what's a piece of Broadway, what's a piece of data we want to know about you? Okay, just talk, put it right up to him and talk, okay?
Like, oh, that's awesome. I love front row seats.
Okay, and up in the loft, we've got another mic. Maybe we put the house lights up just a little bit. Can we pass that mic to somebody? What's something else we want to know about you?
Hi. discount codes could last longer.
Okay. How many people here love discount codes? And how many of you are producers, and when you think about discount codes, you have a funny view about it? Well, we'll keep collecting some data, so hold on to that, but you'll be tossing it in a moment. Now, I want to show you something that I get excited and they get confused about. The selfie. The selfie. Now, you know, when you want to think about Broadway marketing, we have, you know, American in Paris opening and Allegiance later and others. We think about putting ads in Times and all the like. I get obsessed with selfie marketing. Selfie marketing, okay? Imagine if we could influence selfie marketing, that everybody who went to the show either before or after, God, I say during, but I'm not going to say that, but at before or after, took a wonderful selfie. Now, do me a favor, once again, this is slightly interactive. I'd like you to turn to your neighbor. What is the role of a selfie in marketing and growing Broadway sales in that process? So just turn to your neighbor. Think about optimizing selfies. Hello? Owners of our throwable mics, would you toss it to somebody else upstairs and downstairs? Just throw it, don't worry, have faith, okay. So, sir, okay, what do you think the role of a selfie might be about how we market a show?
So it's social media marketing. I mean, you're advertising where you are to all your closest friends. It's word of mouth.
Imagine if 1,000 people come to your show and each one of them sends a wonderful selfie to 10 people. And imagine if that selfie not only would be maybe a picture of them, you can go see somebody who would put their head in Kinky Boots and they look like Lola and the like. But imagine if not only it did that, but it personalized it, and it linked back to the site, And maybe for those of you who want, it got a discount code, you know, and the like. But imagine that. Now, up on the top, somebody have that microphone.
Hey,
what might a selfie do?
So we actually were talking, and we thought that it shows that you cared about the show and that you enjoyed it so much that you would want to take a picture and send it everywhere, and that you just really loved it and you want everybody else to see it. So it's along the same lines.
You're documenting it, because part about stories are telling a story about a story. Broadway is about stories, and to the extent that we can take a story and we can tell a story. Now, I would argue, as we start to look at marketing, as we start to look at Broadway, it is about making those connections. And I'm not saying it's all about going online. It's not about going online. It's about how we connect people. Now, the interesting element is, in your audience are people who are connected. So how many of you have one mobile device with you here? How many of you put two hands up, have two mobile devices? Bob your head if you have three mobile devices. Okay, now, how many of you have sent something while you're sitting here already? Now, I want you to understand in that process, and I'm not suggesting we tried it at Godspell, we had a tweet night, and some people loved it, and some people hated it, and my actor friends would kill me if they thought you were in front taking pictures. But how do we ultimately evolve the experience to be a bit more personalized? How do we create it more personalized? Now, the reality is, as we think about big data, it's not always about a corporate view of big data. Some of it is also about my data about me. So I want to take you back a little bit in history. Some people are like me. I'm real excited. I'm going to be 65 in May, and I'm an excited boomer. And some of you are in your 20s, and we've got our young professionals. But I'd like you to go back in history a little bit, just a little bit, to television in the old days. This could have been my family, but my parents just gave me a brother that I don't like, so I swapped him out and put a daughter in there instead. But we sat in our living rooms, and we watched Ed Sullivan. It was a communal learning experience. It was a communal entertainment experience. But now, real quickly, with your neighbors, how is TV different today? When you think about TV today, how is it differently? Once again, 30 seconds with your neighbor. How is TV different? Hello? Toss the mic. Okay, throw the mic up. Yeah, don't worry. Okay, how is TV today different for you? Okay.
I have three children. And we all watch on our own devices.
Right, okay. So you're watching it on multiple devices. Upstairs, can we pass the mic?
Yes, so I guess now we can actually connect with the entire world through tweets and Facebook, and then there's 1,000 ways we can watch a show, when we can watch the show, how we're gonna watch the show. So right. It's a lot different than your time back in the day.
So. And what I love is my people, we dominate the purchasing market. But our problem is we've got to also personalize it so it is as exciting and valuable to go to a Broadway show if you're 17, if you're 27, if you're 47, if you're 77. And I would argue that to do that, we've got to understand that their world is changing. We've gone from 3 channels to 400 channels. We've gone to be involved in an area where, in fact, we sometimes might be looking at an empty theater because they've got so many things that they might do at home. But I would argue that when we start to look at data and where we're going, we better get ready. And I'm not just a techie. I am a techie, but I love to see about how technology can enable things that are not about technology. For instance, in a couple of weeks, Apple will come out with their watch, and there are ones from other folks as well. Imagine for a moment if you were the writer, the director, the producer of a Broadway show what would you want your app to look like on a watch? What would that look like in that sense? Jim and I were talking about, what if we could swap it around and I could, as an audience member, sell myself to the theater? Not doing anything tonight. This is what I'm willing to pay. This is my interest. Okay, bid for me. And by the way, I do big meals with big wines. Bid for dinner as well in that process. Well, when we start to think about that, imagine these little things, okay, these little beacons that you see are gonna show up in theaters. And they're gonna show up so that the individual who comes in or goes by could literally walk by the theater and there could be a pop-up on their screen and a message from your star talking about why they would want to do. Imagine, we're gonna be producing George Takei. If George can pop up at your screen as you walk by our theater in that sense. Or what do we even imagine, and I think it's an interesting question, if we were doing previews, how would we gather data from the audience during the previews that would really help us crank it up and evolve it in that process? Ladies and gentlemen, there are many things we can talk about in terms of big data. I would argue three things, and then we'll tell you about hackathon and close out. Number one, we have got to get in Broadway to the area where we are delighting our customers, where our customers are delighted. And we're going to have to deal with difficult things. We are bigger, the seats are smaller. People are scrunched in that stuff. We've got shows, they're wonderful, but they exceed the average bladder length by act. So we're gonna have to map to the big data of bladder capacity in that process along the way. We're going to have to deal with the fact that we're going to always be making more and more and more choices. We're gonna have to think about how do we, as we get older, and that's my cohort, I want to go to a show, but I can't remember its name. How does it remind me of that? You know, annoy me about that in that process. Or even better yet, who's that on stage? You know, so I can scan for that. We're going to have to deal with literally multiple demographics at once that we are going to have to market to, pitch to, engage, and the like. And I would argue that all of this, all of what big data is about, is not a statistical analysis. Backstage, I was with some of the most creative writers and music writers and producers. You know what we all have in common? We're curious. We're curious how we take that great story and how that story can be told well, impactfully, and hopefully either profitably or at least to make back our expense in that process. So we want to invite you to something. Masie Productions, along with Jordan Roth and his organization and Ken Davenport, we're putting together a little interesting experiment, and it's called a Broadway Hackathon. Now, a hackathon is the ability to get a bunch of very young, techie, probably students together, not pay them anything, give them pizza and some other food over a weekend, and put them to work on an interesting element of how would we build our technology with big data that would allow us to create a connected Broadway. What does an app look like where you could sell me out? What's an app look like when you go to a preview? What's an app look like for somebody who literally, I'm playing now with Translate Skype, where literally you will be able to be on Skype and get in your ear real-time translation. Imagine when we migrate from the recorded translation into an in-your-ear real translation to 130 languages at once. Now, are we ready for it? No. Do we have to be ready tomorrow? No. But we think what better way than engage some college students, even some high school students from Stuyvesant High School. And we've asked the young professionals here, some of you who are up in the loft, are you up there? Can I hear from the young professionals? Make some noise. We want to ask you to do something. You're not going to build the code. We want you to do the brainstorm. If we could create this spring some super little apps that went on, digital devices or a phone, what would they look like? So I'll be rejoining you with Jonathan during our break, and we're gonna get you to brainstorm, and then this spring, we're gonna pull together some young people to come out with an instant development process. It won't take 6 months. We're gonna do it in 24 hours, and we will put it back in open source and share it with all of you here at TEDx. So ladies and gentlemen, at the end of the day, our goal with big data is not about doing statistical analysis, but to understand, to make what he said at the beginning come true, Broadway better than it is. We've got to be learners, we've got to be curious, we've got to be experimenters, and we have to together link the past with the future. Thank you very much. Go TEDx!